Oh, hello everybody! It's time for Rufus's latest adventure, and it's called the Great Easter Egg Caper. What's a caper? Well, it's a sort of olive. It's called the Great Easter Egg Olive. We might have to work on the title. Oh, we hope you enjoy the show. I think I can hear the music now. And we'll see you after the story. Yeah.
That morning, Rufus the castle dog had been extremely busy. Smudge, the bunny rabbit, had asked Rufus to help her organise the annual Easter egg hunt. All the animals in the village had been told to meet at the Great Cave at 12 noon. Nobody had been missed out, from Jackson the Jackdaw to Cora the Caterpillar, from Baron von Smilderbeans the Bat to Sydney Snail. Everyone had been told, and everyone was excited. Posters had been made, bunting had been put up, and Rufus again had been given the task of hiding all the Easter eggs in the forest. It was the most important task of the morning. Smudge still had a lot of things to do, and she knew she could rely on Rufus, who wagged his tail and immediately went to work because he did not have a moment to lose. Rufus carefully placed the Easter eggs around the forest. He placed one egg by a cluster of crocuses, the next by some bluebells, and another by a patch of daffodils. And before long, all the eggs had been hidden, except for the big basket of chocolate Easter eggs, which was the prizes for everyone who had taken part. Rufus finally placed the basket of presents beside the great cave where everyone was to meet. The game was simple. When the whistle blew at 12 noon prompt, everyone had to find the hidden eggs. The game was a lot of fun. But then Rufus suddenly heard a sound. It was like a rather large snuffle. If snuffles could make a sound. Rumph, waffle, rumph, went the noise. It was coming from the great cave. Luckily, Rufus knew who lived there, so he knew who was making all the noise. It was the king of all the forest, Saxon, the great big brown bear. The wolves and the wildcats were always up to mischief, so Saxon the bear made sure everyone in the forest lived together in peace and harmony. A growl from Saxon could easily sort out any trouble. Rufus listened carefully. The snoring went quiet. Then it went loud. And then it went louder. Rufus was so excited about the Easter egg hunt that he bounded into the cave without even thinking, and as quick as he could whacked his tail 3 times and then jumped upon the big bear's belly and licked his face 4 times as if to say, "Wake up or you will miss all the fun of the Easter egg hunt." The great bear slowly stretched, squinted, and then sneezed with such a force that it sent Rufus flying across the cave.
"Is that the time already?" asked Saxon.
Rufus wagged his tail.
I think I may have overslept," said Saxon. "The last thing I remember was Wilfred the Wild Boar telling me one of his stories about a parrot and a kangaroo, and I must have dozed off for at least 8 months.
Rufus could understand, for he had often felt sleepy at one of Wilfred's stories, especially the one about the parrot and the kangaroo. A cuckoo chirped outside of the great cave, and Saxon soon realised that it was almost time for the Easter egg hunt.
Rufus, have you hidden all the eggs?
Rufus nodded.
Well done, my boy. If there is one animal in the whole of my kingdom that I know I can rely on, it is you.
Rufus felt so happy.
Let the celebrations begin, because I can already hear some chitter-chatter and commotion outside, and I am sure everyone would like an Easter egg.
Rufus agreed. Saxon slowly slumbered out of the great cave with Rufus by his side. And Saxon was right. Everyone was waiting outside. Smudge immediately hopped over to Rufus and thanked him for all his hard work.
You are such a special friend, Rufus.
Rufus beamed and blushed. Saxon cleared his throat and in his deep booming voice said,
Spring has well and truly arrived, and now for some fun. Ready, steady, go.
And with that, Rufus blew his dog whistle as loud as he could, and everyone ran off to find the eggs, except for Sydney the snail, who decided to take it all at a slower pace because he was already next to a cluster of crocuses. Rufus knew Sydney was not as fast as all the others, so he always put one here for his friend to find. But Sydney could not find an egg. He looked everywhere, but there were none to be found. Sid felt sad. Baron von Spilderbeans was near the primroses, but after searching for over 10 minutes, got into such a flap and a fluster, he simply said,
I fear the acquisition of these confectionery delights is not possible. They cannot be found, old bean, not anywhere.
Rufus glanced at the spot where he had put the egg, but it was gone. Someone had taken it. Cora, the caterpillar, had spent a lot of time by a beautiful butterfly bush, but now decided to sit on the big boulder next to the great cave. She could not find anything and had enough of this silly game. She looked quite furious and decided to have a good sulk. Rufus looked for the basket of Easter eggs by the big boulder next to the great cave, but nothing was there. The basket and all its prizes were missing. Everyone had been searching and searching, but no one could find any eggs. This was no longer fun. Searching for something that was not there was not funny.
I must say, Rufus, one is quite disenfranchised by the whole rotten situation. Skullduggery is all I can say. Skullduggery, said the Count.
Bayek, I think I agree with the Count. I think, said Sid.
Cora just looked so cross that she could not say a word. She was so furious.
Wilfred, the wild boar, however, was just about to begin to tell a story about someone who tried to steal the crown jewels of England when Saxon let out a small growl. Everyone immediately fell silent.
I'm sure there is an explanation, said the wise old bear,
and he slowly turned to Rufus.
I'm sure our friend Rufus can explain.
All eyes stared at Rufus, even Smudge, who was wiping away a tear. She felt so let down by Rufus and couldn't believe her ears. Because Rufus said nothing. Rufus simply stared back because he did not know what had happened. The wolves, who often caused mischief, usually only came out at night, and the wildcats would have also have left tracks. But there was no footprints to be found, and more importantly, it would have been wrong to blame it on the wolves and the wildcats without any proof. So Rufus kept quiet and felt sad, and everyone just stirred. It was as if the eggs had literally been plucked out of thin air and vanished. Suddenly, Rufus realised what had happened, and that was the answer. They had been plucked out of thin air.
It must have been a bird. But not any bird.
A naughty one at that. In the silence, Rufus pricked up his ears and began to listen. Up above him, amongst the tallest of pine trees, Rufus could hear a caw, caw, caw. It sounded like someone laughing to themselves. It was Jackson the Jackdaw, who sat in a new nest that he had made from an Easter basket full to the brim with Easter eggs. Rufus slowly gazed upwards, and everyone began to look upwards too. Cora the Caterpillar was not impressed with Jackson and gave him one of the most disappointed looks she could give, followed by a loud tut. Even Saxon looked angry. But instead of growling, he simply flicked one of his large paws towards the tree so that it dramatically shook, wobbled, and caught Jackson the Jackdaw quite off guard, and before he knew it, he had tumbled out of the branches and landed with a bump and a thud onto the forest floor. This was followed by the Easter eggs bouncing off the top of his noggin, one at a time, and finally the Easter basket landing on Jackson's head, which made him look as if he was wearing a very nice Easter bonnet. By now, Jackson realised that he was not clever, and he decided to stop cawing and started to feel very sorry for himself instead.
The Count looked shocked and spoke first. Well, I say, I am truly sorry, Rufus, for ever doubting you, old bean, this unscrupulous chap. Can I call him a cad, a common crow, who was cheating by taking all the eggs from himself before the game had even begun. Was hoping to blame you. And to think we nearly believed him.
My egg, said Sid, taking off his cap. I'm really frightfully sorry, Rufus. I think what the Count has said is right.
Cora just stared even harder at Jackson, even more than she had before, and this time she gave him two extra tuts. Jackson started to feel uncomfortable, very uncomfortable indeed.
Saxon cleared his throat and addressed the whole forest.
When you play any game, you have to play fair.
It is also wrong to take something that does not belong to you.
Saxon's big brown eyes then turned towards Jackson.
But it would have been far worse if you had started to lie, Jackson, and blame someone else and keep all those eggs for yourself.
Everyone agreed. But it was Rufus who spoke most wisely of all, and he whispered in Saxon's ear.
I quite agree, Rufus, said Saxon. Imagine, Jackson, if you had kept all those eggs for yourself. Think of all the fun you would eventually miss out on. By being naughty all the time, you miss out on making the best friends. And there's so much more fun to be had when you share and care with others. It is only then that real magic can happen.
Rufus beamed with joy, and Jackson immediately apologized to Rufus and then said sorry to everyone.
Saxon began to laugh. A laugh of joy which shook the whole forest that even the wolves and the wildcats could hear.
Cora, the caterpillar, said she had made a picnic and wanted to share it with everyone. Sydney Snail said he had brought a packet of marshmallows with him and had enough for everybody and wondered if they could toast them around a campfire. What a good idea, thought Rufus. Smudge and Jackson collected brambles, branches, twigs for a campfire, and Count Baron von Spilderbeans knew a trick where he could use his monocle to light a fire whilst the wise old bear, Saxon, supervised. Jackson shared out all the eggs, and soon there was much laughter, and everyone said it had been the best Easter egg hunt ever, even though technically not one single egg had been found. They all sat around the campfire and began to sing songs. And there was even time before bed for a story. Wilfred suddenly remembered one about a parrot and a kangaroo. And everyone started to feel sleepy.
Hello, boys and girls. That was a good story by Wilfred, wasn't it? The parrot and the kangaroo. Well, all that is left to say is that both me and Rufus wish you a wonderful, happy Easter. Take care, everybody, and see you all again.